Casper had to cut its valuation pretty dramatically by half. What's going on here, and what led to this dramatic cutback?
Casper has been on the road with investors for the past few weeks on its roadshow to see what demand would be for its IPO. So clearly demand didn't come in very strong, and they had to take this very unusual step, cutting the valuation almost in half from the $1.1 billion valuation it had just a year ago. So now it's looking like if the company goes public and starts trading tomorrow, it'll be at about $500 million or lower. So this is really dramatic, but it makes sense with what we've seen in the IPO market, where unprofitable companies just don't find a lot of love on Wall Street.
So, well, I guess it depends on which type of unprofitable companies. I mean, one of the knocks on Casper has been this idea that they don't really have a recurring revenue stream, like, say, a software company might. What was the pitch that the bankers were making to investors out there that seemed to fall flat?
Casper was trying to hype its growth in the $432 billion sleep market, and they wanted to look beyond mattresses. They have things like lights that you put by your bedside, and they were looking into other wellness products. So they were trying to get investors to trust them that they would find other avenues of growth, and they're also focused on their revenue growth, which is at 20%, which isn't bad for a company in the consumer space. But is it a tech valuation? It seems like investors balked at that notion.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the only thing techie about Casper is that you can buy it online. And I suppose there's that, but it does have some physical presence.
You can buy everything online,
Scarlett. There you go. Thank you, Romain. Target has an investment in Casper. Is it going to lose its investment in the company?
They're an early investor in the company, but Target didn't come in early enough, so they could lose a lot of money in this deal. They probably won't sell their shares right away, though, so we'll see how it performs. If at this lower valuation, investors do get excited, Target could make some money down the road. It'll really depend on how the shares trade when it prices the shares today and starts trading tomorrow. Should all go well.
All right. So, Liana, I mean, the IPO market this year hasn't been awful. I mean, maybe it's not at the pace it was last year, but we've had some successful ones. Reynolds did quite well. You had One Life Healthcare, which I believe is backed by Google. That's had a pretty good run since it debuted. I mean, what's the general appetite out there right now for IPOs this year so far?
Those IPOs definitely did well, but they're sort of more boring, stable companies. That's what investors are gravitating towards, profitable companies that might have private equity backing. Today, there's also another company going public called PPD that's backed by private equity and is really solid growth. So investors are looking at these companies, and they're being choosier and not going for these big consumer names that everyone knows.